I just want a Picasso.
Hello, it's Sharick LaMay here of LaMayday.com, and we are at Windmark Recording Studios in Santa Monica, California. Look, I'm talking to an amazing canvas artist by the name of Knowlwdge Bennett. We're showcasing his series, Cojones, here today. A lot of recognizable faces that you're going to see within his art pieces. We're going to talk to him and figure out a little bit about what pushes and motivates him in his art. So stay tuned. You're going to love it. All right. This is Sharick LaMay here with LaMayday.com, and I am here with Knowlwdge Bennett, the man of the hour. How are you today?
I'm doing pretty good. Pretty good. Thanks for coming out.
Thank you. Yeah. So this is all about you today. This is about Cojones. Tell me a little bit about Cojones and what brought everybody out this evening.
Well, Cojones is one of the latest series that I've been working on and exhibiting from New York to L.A. to Miami within the last year or so. And it's basically a representation of the epitome of, like, courage. You know, the series consists of various different popular figures, you know, from old and new, juxtaposed and, you know, meshed and, you know, married to one of my favorite photographs as a child, you know, a photograph of Slick Rick that was captured by a woman by the name of Jeanette Beckman back in 1989. And it was something that, you know, 2 years ago I just had this vision that I wanted to do something with the work. Coming off the heels of another series that I did before that, my Obama, you know, Cowboy Obama series, which was a play on Andy Warhol's Elvis painting back in 1963. That was one of my favorite pieces that Andy made. And then I had this image in my head of this one of my favorite photographs as a child. So after I did the Obama, you know, Cowboy, I was like, what's next, right? And when that image of Slick Rick popped in my head, I was like, I have to do something with it.
Tell me, you picked these particular artists. So we had the Beyoncé's, you had the Michael, Tupac, my favorite.
Yeah, okay.
So how did the process of you picking these particular artists come about?
Well, basically, it started off with Obama. So I started off with him. But then I wanted the series conceptually to start to represent a little more than just what is it like to be famous and then, you know, be courageous. I wanted to start having these dialogues, you know, with the pieces. So I went ahead and I created maybe, I think, 8 or 9 different hip-hop characters. That those hip-hop characters, I first exhibited them with President Obama. And I wanted to speak to the relationship or the correlation between hip-hop and politics. Because growing up, you know, in the 80s and, you know, late 80s and 90s and so forth and so on, that was something that we've seen, you know, time and time again, where hip hop contributed to the discussion, you know, or caused certain discussions to be had within the realm of politics, you know, by artists using their voices to empower, you know, the powerless. You know what I mean? So these are people who I come up under, right? So I get this inspiration from them, and then, you know, you'll see it spill over into the canvas, you know, because this is my means of expression.
I have one last question I ask everybody I interview, because LaMayday.com, I call it my love letter to creative and artistic souls. If you could write one love letter to someone or something, who or what would that love letter be to?
I would write a love letter to my mother. You know what I mean? She, because she often gets overlooked in this process. I'm constantly super busy. She's constantly, like, I don't want to use the term hounding, but she's like, you know, she's on me. She wants to know. Like, she sees things by way of social media just like everybody else. Mm-hmm. And sometimes that's, like, frustrating for her because she's like, why didn't I hear it from you first? You know, why do I got to be just like everybody else? But, matter of fact, you're going to make me sit down and write a letter to my mother.
Write a love letter to mom. We love you, mom.
Yeah, so that's what it'd be, too.
Awesome. Well, thank you for talking to us. Thanks, and good luck to you. And where can they find you social media?
Knowlwdge _ Bennett, that's Knowlwdge _ Bennett, and that's Instagram.